If you are bored with the photos in your profile and looking for an alternative image, I will show you how to create an image like this, and we will do it with Photoshop. I want to edit this image as a profile photo. So we are going to work quickly on this image and try to create a profile image. The original photo is like this, but I want it to face to the right instead of to the left. So I need to unlock the layer first. I need to click on the lock in the layers panel so that this layer is unlocked and I can edit it. I click on the lock. As you can see, this is no longer a locked layer. I can edit it however I want. I press Ctrl T. T is for transform. And I right click and choose flip horizontal. So I flip my image to the right. I confirm by pressing enter. In order to make a profile image, I need to separate the main object from the background. If you are using the latest version of Photoshop, you can do the same as me. If you are not using the current version, if you are using the old version, you need to decoupage around the image with the pen tool. Since I'm using the current version, I'm going to use a nice method. In the toolbox on the left side, I hover over the quick selection tool, and when I hold it down, you will see the object selection tool option. When you select this tool, in order to separate the main object from the background, I need to enclose the object I want to separate from the background, in this case the person, in a rectangle. I click the mouse somewhere and make my selection to select this man like this. After making the selection, let's zoom in. Let's see if we were able to make a correct selection. I see here that the phone can't select a part of the phone. So I'm selecting this area by pressing the shift key on the keyboard. And when I press the shift key, you will see that there is a plus sign over my cursor. With the plus sign, let's select the areas that should be like this and they will be included. That's how I can quickly select the areas that need to be included. It is not included part of the back. Let's select these areas. I do this by pressing the shift key and then I press the alt key to prevent it from picking up the places I don't want it to pick up. When I press alt, you will see the minus sign on my cursor. I don't want to take that range. So I include that range in the selection. And so it cancels that area because I press alt. Generally successful. Now let's click on the select and mask button. In this window, we will click on output settings to make sure that the selected area is output in a masked form. So let's not only select selection, but also new layer with layer mask and click OK. And as you can see, it has created a new layer and decoupled it into the mask. After decoupling the image, we will draw a circle in the background. In order to draw a circle, I will use the ellipse tool here. I'm using ellipse tool by pressing shift like this. So we can draw a full circle. I'm drawing an average sized circle. I take the selection tool and press Ctrl A to center this circle. Make sure the ellipse is selected. I center this circle both horizontally and vertically. So the circle is centered on the workspace. And I cancel the selected parts by pressing Ctrl D. Now we can start working. What should be the color of this image? We need to decide that first. It can be in shades of yellow. Then I need to move the ellipse tool to the background. So you need to bring the image you decoupled, to the front. We are using the layer logic here. And so I drag the bottom image onto the circle. I'm also thinking how I need to place the image. Let's make it a little bit smaller. With this layer selected, I'm pressing Ctrl T and enlarge the image a little bit. The idea is to leave some of the decoupled object out of the circle, so we can get a more beautiful image. The image has grown. I could edit this right away. Let's even name it. Now, follow my steps carefully. With the image selected, I press Ctrl G. I group this. After grouping, I activate the mask. Then, I press Ctrl and select ellipse. So the boundaries of the ellipse are selected. It is still active here. I take the brush tool. The shortcut of the brush tool is B. While the color in front is black, I will paint the places except the man's back. But since the inside of the circle is currently selected, we will remove the inside. Therefore, we need to inverse. Select inverse option. This is the shortcut. With inverse, we make the area outside the circle selected. Now we can paint it like we just did. When we paint here, the areas we painted here will not be visible because we masked them. And I cancel this selection with select, deselect. As you can see, this is how we have created a profile photo. I can select all of these and move them around. I can put another color in the background. As an extra, I can give it an outline. You can organize them according to what you want to do. It is not just a photo, but we were also able to create a profile image by adding a few things on it. So, in this tutorial, I showed you a simple way to create a profile photo. We have worked on the masks within the layers. I hope that was useful. If today's video was useful, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.